framework SDK and everything else which is required for execution or for development of various types of .NET applications are automatically installed. We do have Express edition of Visual Basic, Express edition of C Sharp, and Express edition for web development. But then there are different softwares. Studio Advantage is, it's everything at one place. Let us see now the different versions of .NET framework. Version 1.0 was released in the year 2002. Version 1.1 was released in the year 2003, 2.0, 2005, 3.0, 2006, 3.5, 2008. Advantage of all this is all the versions you can install on your machine side by side. You can download framework 1.1, install on your machine. Framework 1.0, you can install on your machine. 2.0, 3.0, 3.5. All the frameworks can be installed on your machine at one place. It's not like if you have 2.0, you will not install 1.1. It's not like that. You may install 1.1 and you may also install framework 2.0. Now, .NET Framework 1.0 was a standalone version. 1.1 also was a standalone version and 2.0 is also a standalone version. Now, what exactly it means? Suppose if you have used .NET Framework 1.1 for development of your application and if you want to deploy your application on another machine, even if that machine has .NET Framework 2.0, your application is not going to work unless on that machine also you install .NET Framework 1.1 only. I repeat, something not usual, something unusual. Development platform, development version of .NET Framework and the production version of .NET Framework must be same. A future version or a previous version will not work. If I have used .NET Framework 1.1 for development, on the target machine also I must have .NET Framework 1.1 only. If you put 2.0 framework version, it is not going to help. It will not be useful. And not 1.0 would be useful. That means .NET Framework is not like forward compatible or backward compatible. Similarly, if you have used .NET Framework 2.0 for development, on the target machine also you should have .NET Framework 2.0. But then 2.0 has a special feature of being a base version over and above which 3.0 or and above which 3.5 will be installed. What does it mean? See, if you are working with .NET Framework 3.5, not necessary that that machine must have .NET Framework 1.0 or 1.1. But that machine will also have 3.0 framework version and 2.0 framework version. What Microsoft did is, they made 2.0 as the base version and then they extended with certain additional features in 3.0. For example, WCF, Windows Communication Foundation, WPF, Windows Presentation Foundation, Windows Card Space, and Windows Workflow Foundation. These four are the enhancements in .NET Framework 3.0. Otherwise, everything remains same as in .NET Framework 2.0. So 2.0 is the base version. Over and above that, this extra features, the four things, WCF, WPF, WF, and Windows Card Space, WC. These four things are additionally supported on 2.0. So that becomes 3.0 version. Above this, Microsoft has further extended with few more new features like LingQ, Ajax.NET, and so on for giving us a .NET Framework 3.5. In 3.5, certain language enhancements are also given in C Sharp and VB.NET. But 3.0, there is no language enhancement. 2.0 remains as it is, and these four additional components, four additional frameworks, WCF, WPF, Workflow, and Card Space are extra over 2.0. Above that, 3.4. So 3.0 is not a standalone version. 3.5 is not a standalone version. These versions cannot be installed unless you have the immediate previous version on the same machine. So if you have 3.5, you also have 2.0. If you have 3.0, you also have 2.0. I hope it's clear. But if you have used framework 3.5 for development, and if you have not used any of the 3.5 features, if you have used old 2.0 features only for development, remember, a .NET application would execute on those machines which would just have 2.0. But if any one feature of 3.5, if you have used, which generally happens, we surely end up using something or the other when we are using Studio 2008, some feature or the other of 3.5 we will end up using. And in such case, on the target machine also, we must have .NET Framework 3.5. Currently, Microsoft has also released Service Pack 1 for 3.5 version. The biggest enhancement in the Service Pack 1 is .NET Entity Framework. That means certain something more better than Linkue. We have Linkue given in 3.5. Over and above that, now Microsoft has given Entity Framework for working with different types of database application. Anyways, that is out of context now. But that's the major enhancement in 3.5. So this is what I said, doesn't support forward or backward compatibility. The version used for development and the production machine must be same. That is, if version 1.1 has been used for development and on the production machine, even if 2.0 is installed and if 1.1 is not, then the application will not work. That means latest version available exists, current version not available, that will not work. Whatever version is used, same version must be available on the target machine also. The core of .NET Framework. I would say .NET Framework is basically divided into three layers. On top, we have got application services. Below that, we can have .NET Framework base class libraries, right? And third layer is common language runtime. Each of these things we have to go in detail now. This is basically the layer. You can see operating system. Above the operating system, we have got something called as common language runtime. Above that, .NET Framework base classes. These are all .NET Framework base classes, same color. And above this, we use different programming languages. We can use C++, C#, VB.NET, Perl, J#, different programming languages. And for all these programming languages, we have common base class library, which executes over CLR, which sits over a given operating system. We'll elaborate more on this as we go further. Let us now spend some time on different types of application we can develop in .NET. I would say this is the list, but this is not the complete list. A lot of things can be added. So using .NET, one can develop console-based application, also referred as command line argument application. Using .NET, you can develop Windows-based application, that is GUI applications, graphical applications. Graphical applications earlier were very popular in Visual Basic. Actually, graphical application, WinForm application are made up of two things. One is referred as Control API and the other is referred as Drawing API. Two APIs are going to make Windows-based application. Controls means button, checkbox, label, dialogues, menus, toolbar, status bar, progress bar, slider. These things come under controls category. Whereas under drawing category, drawing API, we have things like drawing line, rectangle, ellipse, using various types of GDI devices like pen, brush, font, drawing of images, bitmaps, icons, that is drawing part of it. The earlier major problem industry faced was Visual Basic 6.0 was very good for control API. VC++ 6.0 was very good for drawing API. So if one had to develop an application which needs both control and graphics extensively, it was really a tough decision to decide what to use. Probably the only choice then what was to use VC++, and VC++ was not that easy. Visual Basic was much easier for development of GUI based application, but graphic support almost equal to, I would say, zero. So now what Microsoft did is they made WinForms API, which is pretty easy to use for graphics as well as for control API. Mix of both graphics API and WinForms API, graphics API and drawing API, you are going to find in WinForms, and it's a common API.